another type, large scale fixed shops, we completed the departmental stores. Now multiple shops, third one, mail order, trade, fourth one, consumers, cooperative, consumer cooperative stores. There are the four we have in large scale fixed shops. The first one we are completed, departmental stores, advantages as well as the disadvantages. Now second one, multiple shops. Here means is what? Multiple shops in one room itself, in different places. Like just now I said in the previous for departmental stores, here RS Brothers, various places their branches will be there. Multiple shops are there for them. So they will be doing business with that. In one area itself, another Kugadapalle area, or Abbots area, or Sikindrabad area, Hirkaitabad area, like that, different areas, they are establishing the shops. So automatically those will be the multiple shops. They, with that, they are buying and selling the goods and services. This is what we have here. Now the, with these shops, huge amount is required, obviously we can say. Compulsory, there is a huge, large, high amount is required for establishment, this type of multiple shops. So what are the advantages with these multiple shops? First one, there are reach to one and all. Each and everyone will get this products from this multiple shops. Here only habits, one shop only there. Who are there in the Shamshabad itself, they can't come and buy the product. But in different areas, in different shops, they are opened. So the particular customer nearest one go and buy their interested products. They may be here, the customer will be there. He may go for this. He may go for nearest one. Like that, it is possible. So that, what is that here? With the help of the multiple shop, they may be reached to one and all. Every customer, it will be reached. Secondly, they sell standardized products, standardized branded items, perfect items they may be sold. Otherwise, total bad name for their shops are all. Some sort of unbranded item or defective item sold from this will be spread over to all shops. There is a lot of problem, so that they will be maintained standards. So standardized products only they sell to the customers. That is also another advantage. Consumers respond is a lot. They seen everywhere. Customers will be attracted for these multiple shops. So automatically everywhere it will be seen. So automatically they will be go. So there also there is more and more demand there. So here also I go for that shop only, because lot of shops are there. They will be buy from manufacturer in bulk and distributing the various shops in different branches. And so that they will be give sale rate is less. So like that I feel like I may go for that shop, multiple shops who are there. So that is another advantage. So consumers are responsible a lot for everywhere they are observing this type of shops. They helps in the eliminating the middleman. Before that, this type of multiple shops is not there. Different areas, we have different owners will be there, that through they are establishing. Here one time itself, one single owner through a lot of multiple shops are open in different places. At that time, in nearest, all retailers will be eliminated. So direct customer goes to this multiple shop only. Here different retailers are eliminated. That is another feature. It helps in eliminating the middlemen. And it is in division of work will be there. Division of specialization also will be provided. Here one person, here one person, like that. Wherever the problem arising for the maintenance of the anything, the stock maintenance or financial maintenance or operating cost maintenance situation problems will arise, some of the experts on that, those will be giving training to these all the persons. Then automatically the division of work will be up in front of you, as well as the specialization also will be there for particular persons. Like that it will be running successfully, smoothly. So those what we have the advantage for the multiple shops to the shop owners as well as the customers also. Now the for these multiple shops, these are the advantages. They are reached to one and all. They sell standardized products. Consumers are responsible a lot. They seen everywhere this type of shops. They helps in eliminating the middlemen, and established division of work is there, and division of specialization also provided by with these multiple shops. So now for this, we have the disadvantages also. Some of the disadvantages for the multiple shops. So what are multiple shops? Where are that? First one, operating cost is high compared to other type of shops. These multiple shops operating cost is more. Here also there, here, here, like that. Everywhere we have the operating operations are there. For that, most of amount paid. So operating costs are high. Then limited variety of products. Here, what type of products will be sold away here? Here also, here also, here also, here also, here also. And other type of products may not ready to sell. So that is another problem. There is a limited variety of products. The lack of storage capacity. There is no storage capacity at all. Here itself they mentioned some places there is a less space is taken as a rent. At that time there is no storage capacity. So that is what here. If we may take the more space for that, here 50% storage purpose is a waste of money. So that they may be take the small house or small shop, so rent and moving their business. Running their business. So that is the lack of storage capacity. And the required huge capital. There is required more huge capital. Maximum amount will be required for the establishment of the multiple shop. This is what we have the multiple shops advantages as well as the disadvantages. Now second one is over. Departmental advisorship over. Multiple shops over. Now the mail order trade. Mail order trade. Mail order trade means is what? There is a very difficult to trader contact with the customer. At that situation, this mail order business is very, very good for us. Here, there is no direct relation with the customers. There is no need to move forward for customer and explain about it. Initially, the seller will send the mail, means a letter, through regarding the product features, prices, etc. Everything properly written on the particular letter, and that the letter should be mailed to the prospective buyer. Then the particular prospective buyer satisfied with the detailed information which is provided by the mail, then particular buyer may ready to buy your product. At that time you mentioned all and everything. Here you have to pay such so and so of money. So when the buyer may be satisfied that the amount to send through the money order, then the producer or seller may take away this money and send goods through mail and post. Like that will be taken place. Those type of retailers is called mail order trade. This is done with the mail through, so that it will be called as mail order trade. Buying and selling of goods and services with through help of the mail, automatically it will be called as mail order. So here what are the advantages? What are the disadvantages? First one, advantages. First one, capital required is less compared to any way of shops. With this shop, there is a capital is very less is required. There is no need to take the rent of big buildings. One room itself is enough. Some place we have to store it. With this, we have to return the letters and send it to the buyers. Buyers are sending to the letters to you. Then you can send the goods to them like that they are using. So that is what, there is a capital is less compared to other type of fixed shops. Nextly, there is a convenience both buying and selling. It is easy to convenience to buyer and selling. Buyer want to buy it, seller want to sell it. It is very, very convenient compared to other type of shops. Next, the goods are reasonably priced because of there is no operating cost which may not be arise. Some sort of other types of shops, there is operating cost is there. But in mail order business, their operating cost is not there. So automatically the goods are reasonably priced. So automatically customers are very, very happy at all. Because when the customer is happy, then the product is good and rate also will be less. Customer will be well happy. So that's why the goods are reasonably priced in this type of trade. And just operating costless compared to other type of fixed shop, there is a, just now I said no operating cost, but some sort of little bit compared to other type of shops, there is a less and less of operating cost is there. That is another advantage. And eliminating the middleman. Here there is no requirement of the middleman. Direct customer will be send mail to the manufacturer or wholesaler. That the, those will be send the reply to them and buy the particular product to by the buyer, and amount also received by the seller. The like way it will be over the process. So that this is what we have the mail order through advantages. What are they? Capital required is less. There is no convenience both in buying and selling. The goods are reasonably priced and operating cost is less. Middleman eliminated. This is what advantages.